Welcome back. Let's turn to the story of the Egyptian woman today in our Get Real segment, Emam Ahmed. Once considered the world's heaviest woman, she was discharged today from Mumbai's Saifi Hospital. After undergoing 2 months of weight reduction procedure, Emam will now be treated in Abu Dhabi. Let's take a look at why this surgery has captured the imagination of the medical community and beyond.
37-year-old Egyptian national Emam Ahmed, once the world's heaviest woman, weighed 500 kgs when she arrived in Mumbai for her treatment. And now, as she is discharged from Mumbai Saifi Hospital, Emam has shed nearly 300 kgs, now weighing in at 178 kgs after a 2-month-long treatment. But her hospitalization wasn't without controversy.
Emam Ahmed's last day at Saifi Hospital was also eventful. After VPS Healthcare was going to take care of the further treatment of Emam, refused to sign a discharge report, after which Dr. Deepak Sawant, Health Minister of Maharashtra, was called to find a middle way. Currently, Emam is on the way to Burjil Hospital in Abu Dhabi.
It is in the good note that she is discharged, yes, from the Saifi Hospital. But still, we should keep the patience that she should go to the her respective hospital and she should be well taken care of.
But as Emam left for Abu Dhabi, her sister thanked the doctors for their cooperation.
We have been given all support from the government authorities.
And thank what you. About the ambulance, sir? We have got
safe
an ambulance.
Passage, medical, safe passage is a priority now.
I want to thank all people in India and India for helping my sister. Okay, and all doctors in India also.
From here, the VPH Global Health Service will take over all the proceedings. They will take Emam from Saifi Hospital and transfer her to the Abu Dhabi's Burjil Hospital, where she will get the further treatment for her weight loss and to maintain her weight. In Mumbai with camera person Sai Prasad Patil, Mayuresh Ganpate for India Today.
And let me go to the doctor who really was the person who conducted this successful operation. Dr. Muffazal Lakdawala, Chairman, Institute of Minimal Invasive Surgical Sciences at the Saifi Hospital. Appreciate your joining us. First of all, congratulations, because you had made a promise that you would bring Emam on a bed but allow her to go back on a wheelchair. You seem to have succeeded in that. But what, to your mind, are her chances now of a recovery? Because it appears that she still is someone who may not fully recover.
So Rajdeep, when she came in here, I had promised that she was one of the riskiest patients ever taken on board. Nobody, according to her own sister's admission, no other doctor in the world was ready to accept her case. I took it more as a humanitarian approach. Eventually, we went on to accumulate funds, and I'm really thankful to all the Indian people for accumulating the kind of funds that we did to actually fly her in here. I'm really thankful to the External Affairs Minister, who I tweeted, and she granted a visa in 1 day. So the medical challenges were immense. She weighed 500 kilos, her heart, lungs, liver, kidney, thyroid, everything was deranged when we got her in. So the challenge was whether she'd make a safe flight, firstly, for coming from Alexandria to here. We managed to do that successfully. And then eventually to stabilize her. She had suffered a stroke around 3 years back in Alexandria. And so we had issues with right side paralysis and recurrent scar epilepsy, where she used to off and on get absence seizures. So those were the problems we faced with. When we did get an opportunity, we did diagnose the cause of her obesity as being a genetic leptin resistant gene. In terms of the surgery went uneventful, because most of her comorbidities could get controlled, like the thyroid and liver and lung functions. But that's why she lost so much weight.
I want to understand as a layman about a bariatric surgery. Is it now a surgery, yes, which in your view has reached the stage where it can be performed without any side effects? Or will there be side effects? Already you warned that her going to UAE, you are apparently not in favor of it. Are there a lot of side effects for bariatric surgery which patients should be cautious of? Or is Emam really an outlier case of someone who, you know, has perhaps been an extraordinary case in a way?
So Emam's always been an extraordinary case. You know, we've had no other person who's been 500 kgs and alive. We've had two cases of people who have been around that weight and operated. One died soon after surgery, and one, nobody knows what happened. The important thing is that this was one case which we had prospectively analyzed from day one. Had involved experts from Harvard, from Cambridge, from Melbourne University, and they were not surgeons. So we had involved medical scientists and geneticists all on board to try and get her to lose weight. Eventually, when we did get time, please understand, bariatric surgery is not a cosmetic surgery. It is A, meant for people who've got a lot of side effects per se because of their weight. Someone who's 500 kilos is a living time bomb. She's a massive health risk to begin with. Most of her health risks have come down. She came with a 90% health risk. Today, her health risks when she went are almost 10%. So there are side, you can call it collaterals of having bariatric surgery, not side effects.
You can say that you have to take
multivitamins for life in certain cases.
I just have 30 seconds. Would you say that in most cases now, a bariatric surgery is successful? Would you say 90% successful?
If done in the right center with the right people, yes.
A 90% success rate. So to that extent, you seem to have taken it to another level. Iman, of course, being an extraordinary case, but even in the average case, you're saying there's a 90% successful chance in bariatric surgeries. Thank you very much, doctor, for sharing with us a story that I call as part of our Get Real campaign. We want to get away more and more from the political tutu meme to stories that should really affect and concern you and me. Isn't that what news was supposed to be, after all?